Have you given up consistently reading the Bible because you get bored or you don't understand it or you can't focus? Well, in this video, I'm going to share 10 super practical things that you can do to get more out of your scripture reading. So I used to really struggle with reading the Bible. I would get bored, you know, because I didn't understand and I would lose focus. Some of the books are really hard, like in Jeremiah, I would get really bogged down in Jeremiah, or like Leviticus was just like, just too much. I just like couldn't even get through it. But after I started implementing some of the things that I'm going to share with you today, my time in the Bible just became so much more satisfying and fruitful. So if you're someone who's just beginning to read the Bible, or if you're someone who's been reading for a while but you need to just infuse some fresh life into your Bible time, stick around for these 10 tips. They're really practical and easy, and they'll really help you understand more, get more focused, and not have that bored feeling. So hi, my name is Nancy B. Kline, and this channel is called His Ancient Ways, and on this channel, I share tips and ideas and resources to help you dig into the Bible so that you can know His ways for your life. So sometimes it's really clear, you know, when you're not understanding or that you can't focus. But sometimes you just get bored and you don't know why you're getting bored. But usually when you're getting bored, it's because you're probably not understanding or not engaging with the Bible in a meaningful way. So many of the things that we're going to talk about today kind of fall into two categories. Number one, you just simply aren't understanding it. Or number two, you need to get more engagement. And make sure to stick around to the end of the video because I have a free gift that I want to tell you about that's really going to help up your engagement with the Bible. Okay, so let's get into it. Number one, pray before you read the Bible. Now, I know this sounds like kind of a no-brainer, but honestly, I used to just like open the book and just start reading. And, you know, I never prayed and I just didn't get anything out of it. But listen, God wants you to read His word. And if you pray and you ask for understanding and focus and clarity, He will help you with that. So pray. Number two, get into a distraction-free zone and protect that space and time. So that may mean that you have to get up super early in the morning before everybody else, or it may mean that you have to put a do not disturb sign like on your door. But if this is you, you know what the distraction is and you probably know how to deal with it, or God will just show you how to deal with it. But it has to be, you can't be getting distracted by all kinds of people and kids. Number three, listen to an audio version while you read at the same time. Now, I personally haven't done this. I do listen to audio Bibles, but not while reading at the same time. But I have seen YouTubers talk about this and they say it really, really works. So you can download apps, like say the YouVersion app or the Faith Comes By Hearing app, and you can actually listen to the Bible. And then the key is to get a translation in the same translation that you're hearing, because otherwise it's going to confuse you more. And then read along in your Bible with the audio. And supposedly this really helps a lot. Now I'll link down in the description, YouVersion and also Faith Comes By Hearing. Number four, get a study Bible. Now, when I got my study Bible, it revolutionized my time in the Word. I use the Fire Bible, and it has a lot of great ways that it connects Old Testament to New Testament, makes them really relevant to each other. It has tons of articles. I'm going to be doing a review on it later, so make sure to subscribe so you can watch that video. But honestly, it's a great Bible. And I recommended it to a really good friend of mine and she started using it and she loves it. She's like, oh, I love reading the Bible now. It makes so much more sense. So get a good study Bible. Number five, get an easier translation. So getting another translation, or at least having access to another translation, can really, really help. Now I am going to just give you a short tutorial on different translations. They're on a spectrum. On one end you have word for word, which is as close to the original language as you can get in our language. And then on the other hand, you have paraphrase, which is just somebody putting it in their own words. In the middle, you have something called dynamic equivalent, which is basically word for word when possible, and paraphrase when necessary. So what I would suggest is, if you need an easier translation, is to get one that's closer to a paraphrase. Now, the New Living Translation is actually the one that I like to use. It is a paraphrase, but it's a little bit closer to the dynamic equivalent. And it was a committee translation, not a single author translation. I'm not against single author translations or paraphrases. There's definitely a place for those. But the New Living Translation is just a rock solid translation that's super, super easy. It's recognized as a great translation, and a lot of people use it. Number six, try and find God's characteristics in the passage that you're reading. Now, there's all kinds of different ways to do this. Some people like to find Jesus in the Old Testament. Some people, you know, like to find the Holy Spirit in the Old Testament. What I like to do is I've kind of simplified it a little bit, and I just like to find any characteristic that is of the Father, of Jesus, or of the Holy Spirit anywhere in the Bible, and I have one color for that, and I'm constantly looking for it. So here's the thing, when you're engaging like that, when you're looking for something specific, it makes you focus better. Number seven, put yourself in the text. Now, this is kind of a form of visualization or enacting your imagination, and just kind of trying to imagine what life was like during that time. So you can actually put yourself kind of like in the scene. So this works really well with the narrative books like Genesis or, you know, Judges. A lot of the history books are narratives, or like even Acts or the Gospels. Those are narrative books. So it works really well with narrative books, but it can also work in books like Leviticus. Just like wondering, you know, like what would life had been like in the desert for 40 years, having to do all these weird sacrifices and offerings. I mean, you can imagine that type of thing. So go ahead and activate your imagination, and it'll help to get you engaged. Number eight, start a highlighting system. Now, I've talked about this a little bit already, but yeah, just start highlighting things. Open the Bible with the expectation that you're going to find this or you're going to find that, and you're going to highlight it, and it'll really, really up your engagement. Number nine, don't skip around a lot, although I do have one caveat with that. Now, this is a super practical lesson that I personally learned when I attempted a 52-week genre year in the Bible program. Now, if you don't know what that is, basically what it does is it breaks the Bible up into seven different genres. There's different ways to break up the Bible, but there's like seven different genres that are kind of universally recognized, such as the law and the history and the gospels, but there's seven of them. And basically what this program does is every day of the week, you read in a different genre. What that means is that it takes forever to get through some of the bigger books, like say Jeremiah, which is huge. And it took me forever to get through Jeremiah, and it was so difficult for me to track from week to week because I was only in it one day out of the week. And I even took notes, and I still had a hard time tracking with it. So I don't recommend the 52 genre week Bible reading program to anybody who is just learning how to read the Bible or to anyone who struggles reading the Bible. It's a great program, I'm sure, for people who are really experienced Bible readers. But, you know, at the time when I was doing it, that is not what I needed. So I did say I had one caveat to this, and that is actually reading out of the Old Testament and the New Testament at the same time, especially when you're reading some of the really heavy stuff in the Old Testament. And let's face it, most of it is heavy. But if you're reading like, say, Job or Jeremiah or Numbers, it can just be really rough if that's the only thing that you're reading day in and day out. So what I suggest you do is, like, say you read two or three chapters a day, read one or two of them out of the Old Testament, and then read one out of the New Testament. It'll just help break it up and keep you feeling a little bit more balanced. Number 10, start taking Bible notes. It's also known as Bible journaling. Now, this is the second most important thing that just revolutionized my time in the Bible. Because when you open up the Bible with the expectation that you're going to take notes, or you're going to highlight, or you're going to underline, or you have your notebook, or whatever it is, that expectation forces you to really, really pay attention and get engaged in the Bible. It helped me out tons, and I'm sure it'll help you out too. And that leads me into the free gift that I promised you, which is 35 different ways to take Bible notes in your Bible or in a journal. So this is a great aid for beginning Bible studiers or even people who just want to infuse fresh life into taking Bible notes. So the link to get that is down in the description. You can print it out and just tuck it into your Bible and refer to it whenever you need to. Now, I had another video that I made, which is 5 quick and easy ways to take Bible notes. You can see it over here, so you can check that out. Now, if this video has blessed you, go ahead and hit the like button. It just tells YouTube who to show the video to next, because they'll just find people just like you and show it to them. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.